Hello, Windsor families and staff. Welcome back and Happy New Year. This is your COVID update for January 3rd through January 7th. Updates. CDC guidance. The CDC has released new guidance on a reduced isolation period. According to the CDC, individuals who test positive for COVID may now be released from isolation in 5 days, providing the individuals are symptom-free and wear a mask for the next 5 days. Windsor Unified School District and other local districts are waiting on word from county health officials to see if we can follow the 5-day isolation period guidance from the CDC. California Department of Health aligned with CDC on the 30th. By the time you receive this message, we hope to have sent notification that the county has adopted the 5-day isolation period as well. Along with the 5-day isolation period, California Department of Health has added additional recommended mitigation measures. Notably, vaccinated individuals who are eligible for a booster but have not received it are recommended to quarantine after exposure. Others include 5 days of masking and testing to exit either isolation or quarantine. Updates continued. Health Order C-19-33. This order of the health officer requires public and private schools serving students in transitional kindergarten through grade 12 to require workers to get tested twice a week for the virus that causes the coronavirus or produce satisfactory evidence that they are fully updated against the COVID-19 virus. Dr. Sundari Mase released this new health order that takes effect on February 1st. As of February 1st, in order to be considered fully vaccinated, workers must have completed the first shot or shots in the series and a booster if eligible. Workers who have not completed the first shot or boosters, if eligible, will be required to test twice a week. If you are vaccinated and not yet eligible for the booster, you do not have to test. Updates continued. Testing. Testing lunch hours. Our testing crew needs to eat too. Here is when they are closed for lunch. Windsor High School, 1220 to 1250. Cali, 1120 to 1150. And Windsor Middle School, 12 to 12:30, except on Fridays, they have an extended lunch from 12 to 12:50 as they meet with me to discuss the next week. Our testing crew works very hard to provide you with free testing. They see hundreds of patients a week and put themselves at risk of infection constantly to assist our community. Please remember that they are working as fast as they can and doing their very best. Please be kind to our frontline workers. We're lucky to have them. Testing continued. Brooks Elementary and Maddie Washburn staff. We are trying to figure out a schedule so we can provide on-campus testing twice a week by February 1st. We're struggling to keep up with demand now, and it's been difficult to dispatch the teams on the sites when our testing crew has an absence. Please be patient with updates and changes. I have recently hired a new staff member to assist at the testing site, and they have added one of their own, but the volume of testing over the next few weeks will mean extended waiting times. Please be patient. Testing continued. Registration. A new testing registration link has been released. I'm working with Crisis Go to provide a family tab for family registration. At this point, family members who are neither staff nor students will have to fill out a paper registration. This will hopefully be rectified soon. This link also allows for submission of vaccine records or testing results. The vaccination submission tab is not currently functioning properly. I'm working on the fix this week and will notify you when it's fixed. Volunteers, a huge thank you and props to Susie Rosen, who has completed an easy to follow slide for volunteers who are curious about helping on campus. The slide deck is provided in the push notification if you want to review the information. Welcome back, everyone. We'll see you next week for more updates.